pues empezamos. We start.
Cool.
Cool. Good morning. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. And how are you?
Yeah, fine. Yo siempre empiezo las entrevistas preguntando lo mismo. ¿Por qué haces cine?
He always starts the interviews with a question. Why do you make movies?
I love film. My mother loves film. So I've grew up watching movies all my life. I remember when I was growing up that we didn't go to the cinema a lot because going to the cinema was a treat. It was a lot of money. I come from a working class background. You know, my dad's a painter and decorator and my mum's a social worker. And film was always something that we as a family loved and shared. We would tape movies off the TV and we would save them for Saturday nights and we'd all watch them together. My mum's a huge, huge horror fan. And there's something about making movies for the cinema, as well as for just being a home, but where you can get everybody together. You can all get down behind that silver screen and have that little bit of excitement, that little bit of magic. And when you're in a room full of people, regardless if it's a horror movie, it's a comedy, it's a shared enjoyment and it's escapism. One of the reasons I make movies is for people to escape their problems. Come, enjoy yourself, forget your mortgage, forget your problems at home, forget your problems with your boyfriend or your girlfriend, forget work problems. Just come, get stuck at it, enjoy this. Come along for a ride and enjoy that.
Dice que le encanta el cine. Heredó el amor al cine por su madre, que también le encanta ver películas. Que de pequeño no se podían permitir ir mucho al cine porque es algo caro, porque su padre es pintor decorador y su madre es trabajadora social. Pero lo que hacían es grababan pelis de la televisión para verlas el sábado por la noche todos juntos. Y les encantaba. Entonces, para él, hacer películas es una manera de reunir a gente alrededor de una pantalla y para tener una experiencia compartida y compartir pues esa joya todos juntos. Para él es una experiencia muy, muy social que dar a la gente. Y dice que él hace películas para que la gente se olvide de sus problemas, para que pase un buen rato, para que vengan, se olviden de su hipoteca, de si han discutido con su novio, con su novia, si no lo están pasando bien, que se olviden un rato y se lo pasen bien.
Cuando vaya hablando, ¿se lo puedes ir traduciendo?
Por encima.
Sí.
Vale. So you're gonna talk and I'm gonna talk a bit over you, because that way is a bit more dynamic.
Okay.
So you go on.
Okay.
And I'll go in Spanish a little bit.
Okay.
A mí una de las cosas que más me gusta de la película, aparte de la comedia gamberra con zombies.
So one of the things he enjoys about the movie, other than the comedy with zombies.
Es la introducción del musical.
Is the intro to the musical.
Y me gusta esa introducción porque no rompe el ritmo de la película y además es un musical que critica el propio musical.
He thinks the first song doesn't break the rhythm of the movie and it's a musical that is a criticism of musicals in a way.
Critica el musical mainstream Hollywood, donde siempre se habla de amor, es romanticón, pasteleo, es muy suave. Donde la película es más coreografía y canciones sobre el amor y los sentimientos.
It's nothing like the typical cliché mainstream Hollywood musicals, where it's like a romanticism and everything is nice and love. And everything's a bit empty. It's just singing and dancing, and there's no real concept.
So first and foremost, character is always the most important thing to me in film, and making sure that these characters came across well was always really, really important to us. Making sure that we could. I'm not a musical fan. I'm not an out and out musical buff. When I got this film, I had to go and watch a lot of musicals. And I quickly realized that it was just an extension of storytelling.
Él no es fan de musicales, no lo era. Entonces, cuando lo contrataron para hacer esta película, tuvo que hacer mucha investigación de musicales. Y
So the musical side of it was always something that was always going to be a worry for me and a concern, but just making sure, as I say, there was an extension of storytelling. I never wanted at any point for us to go musical mode, jazz hands, like, you know, I never wanted any of my cast to be musical theatre, like feel musical theatre or sound musical theatre. They all had to have authentic voices.
Para él siempre fue un poco de preocupación esto por su falta de experiencia, pero siempre tuvo muy claro que quería que el musical fuese como una extensión de la historia, que no fuese nada interrumpido, que el casting precisamente no fueran actores que solo tuvieran experiencia en teatro musical, sino que para que no fuera tan impostado, ¿no? Lo que él dice de las manos.
Good jazz hands. I was waiting. Because I'm not the biggest musical fan, and like my favourite musical is South Park, Bigger, Longer and Uncut. And that seamlessly goes in and out of these musical moments that all have a purpose, they all have a reason, and they're all there to drive and tell the story. And for me, that was always the main thing about it, was that we weren't just breaking into song because we were going, oh, that's been 15 minutes, we better put a song in there. Like, what it was each song, as I said, had to drive the characters and drive the story.
Para él era muy importante eso, que la canción no rompiera, que no era como, bueno, cada 15 minutos tiene que haber una canción, o solo porque los musicales es así, sino que acompañara la historia y que fuera del todo natural.
Además, yo creo que hay un momento que define mucho tu idea sobre la película. Idea about the film. Mm-hmm. Se levantan, los dos protagonistas empiezan a cantar como a dúo en diferentes situaciones y a su alrededor está el caos, el apocalipsis, los zombies matándose unos a otros y ellos siguen con su idea cantando y tal. Y ahí rompes esa idea del musical suave que a mí no me gusta nada, ¿no? Y es muy interesante.
So the musical number where the protagonist and her best friend they start singing in each at their houses and then they come in together at the cemetery. For him is this idea that no regular musical does that, like they sing and there's like mayhem around them, and that's like really original for a musical.
It's that idea of that we've all like put our headphones in. And we're walking down the street and a song comes on that you just can't help but like, and you start to sing and you kind of forget everything that's around you because you just kind of get lost in this music, you kind of get lost in whatever song it is that's playing. And I have caught myself so many times, you know, giving it. And you're like, you're looking around and there's people around you, but you kind of just don't care. That is, as well, is just kind of like what millennials are like. I don't know if you've ever sort of like watched them on trains, or you see them like, you know, where they're like, some of them have even got songs playing, like just in the speaker, and they're singing away, and yeah.
Sí, es esa idea de cuando vas por la calle sumergido en tu música, que a veces te pondrías hasta cantar, pero tienes que decir, no, un momento, que estoy en público, ¿no? Esas canciones que son súper pegadizas y que te dan ganas de bailar. Y dice, bueno, con un poco que con algunos millennials, cuando vas en transporte público, que lo hacen, se ponen a cantar, o hasta ponen la canción en los altavoces, que les da igual.
And that idea of being lost in your own head, not only in these two characters who have decided that today's the day that they change it. You know, Anna's going to get on with her dad. She's going to make amends and make this work. And John's going to go and he's going to get himself fit and he's going to show Anna that he can do this, and he's going to be able to come across and like hike across the outback with her. They've got these sort of like real determined moments in the morning where they're like, no, I'm going to go and take like control of my life. I'm going to grab it. And of course they can't take control of it because the whole world's just falling apart around them.
Esa es la idea de la canción, es que los dos personajes es un momento de determinación para ellos, ¿no? John va a superar sus miedos y a demostrarle a Ana lo que vale, y Ana va a conseguir todos sus objetivos, y no pueden porque el mundo alrededor de ellos se está desmoronando.
A nivel de planificación, porque mezclas muchas ideas, ¿no? Está el terror zombie adolescente, las películas adolescentes americanas tontas, el profesor como ogro, porque en realidad los ogros de la película no son los zombies, es el profesor.
So planning wise, it's a bit just like a high school bit and the zombie and the musical, and then the bad people of the movie in fact are like the one body is the teacher, it's not the zombies.
Esa mezcla, ¿fue difícil construirla, que funcionara?
Was it difficult to make all those ingredients work together?
Yeah and no. I knew that.
No.
I knew that we had to give certain moments and beats to particular genres. So the first act, you know, is that zany teen comedy, where we get to understand our characters, we get to know them, and that finishes, and it's actually one of my favourite scenes, and it's the Snow Angel scene, and it finishes there with the two of them sort of just being two kids in a playground, wanting completely different things, but just being themselves.
El primer acto es mucho de la comedia más de instituto, introduce los personajes, los desarrolla un poco, nos los presenta, vamos con ellos, y se acaba un poco ese trozo con la escena de los dos, la protagonista y su mejor amigo en la nieve haciendo ángeles.
Then we begin the second act with those silly horror tropes, those like the high angle, she wakes up on a rye, and then you've got like her jumping out of bed, and we do these quick cuts, and it sits underneath the bed.
El segundo acto empieza ya con los clichés de horror, los homenajes de las pelis de terror, los ángulos altos, los planos homenaje, observarla desde debajo de la cama.
And it all builds towards nothing, you know, her getting a sweet. And it's because it's me saying to my horror, my genre audience, thank you for waiting, thank you very much. Horror comedy is about to ensue. Yeah.
Todos esos planos en verdad son sustos vacíos, no conducen a nada, pero es su manera de decirles a los fans del terror que están esperando a que vengan los zombies, gracias por esperar hasta aquí, ahora viene lo bueno.
We now can have so much fun with this, and we've set up Savage. We know that he's a bit of a horrible teacher, he's not the best, and just making sure that we can show that he's so excited to become this new teacher, this headmaster, and he's going to punish the kids for it. Setting him up like that to make him be able to crack by the end of it was important, going through that, especially once we got into that second act, or the midpoint of the second act, where the things got serious. Because as I said, like, can you go?
El profesor, el malo, lo que sabemos de él al principio es que tiene muchas ganas de tener el poder de la escuela. Entonces, cuando ya empiezas introduciendo a este hombre con estas expectativas, lo haces para que al final pueda revelarse como el malo de la película.
So that means at that midpoint after Human Voice, the song Human Voice, well, like the story for the first time is real taking a dip, you know, and like we've introduced drama. The next time we see Savage is he's having his own drama, which is that everybody's leaving and he's losing control. And being such a control freak was always something to help be able to make him snap and that sort of like, and that build towards that, so that when we got to the third act, we've seen zombies, and Anna can now handle herself, Nick can handle himself, and the other Steph can handle herself. Like, they are, you know, they're still going to be in peril with zombies being around, but they can handle them. Now we've got like the real meat of it, like all zombie movies, when we get to that point, it's people that's always the baddies, really.
Después de la canción Human Voice es cuando empieza ya el todo a volverse más oscuro, más dramático. Tenemos ya, es un punto que para el profesor el malo, el Savage, está empezando a perder el control de la escuela, como no está yendo las cosas como él querría, Y entonces para el final del segundo acto ya tenemos a todos los chicos que ya saben matar a zombies, todos ellos han tenido experiencia, saben desenvolverse. El problema no son los zombies, será enfrentarse con este director que se le ha ido la olla, y para decir que al final los malos siempre somos los humanos.
Me gusta porque no resuelves por qué hay zombies.
He likes that you don't say why there are zombies specifically.
Y eso me interesa porque me acuerdo de dos películas donde no se resuelve por qué hay zombies y punto.
That reminds him of a couple of movies where that's like, there's zombies and that's it, there's no reason for the outbreak.
Que una es La Legión de los Hombres Sin Alma, una película de los años 30.
A 30s movie, The Legend of the Men Without Souls.
Right.
Que está basado en la isla del Dr. Moreau.
Based on the island of Dr. Moreau.
Oh, yeah.
Del 31, 32.
31, 32.
Y después La Noche de los Muertos Vivientes.
And then The Night of the Living Dead.
Porque no te explican por qué hay zombies. Simplemente hay zombies y hay un conflicto que resolver.
Yeah, because there's no explanation. There's just zombies and something to take care of.
Yeah.
Y tú aparte metes el conflicto emocional entre los personajes.
And in your movie there's like the emotional conflict in between all of the characters.
Porque en realidad los zombies es una excusa para mover a los personajes.
The zombies are just an excuse.
I hate when they have a patient zero and it's like this is the beginning of the outbreak and it's because of this and this. I don't like that. Like you, I love Night of the Living Dead, and Night of the Living Dead just starts. Like you can see that for the whole trilogy.
Le encanta La Noche de los Muertos Vivientes. Odia el concepto del paciente cero. De empieza así, empieza así, empieza tal. No, empieza la acción y ya está.
Claro.
Because as well the zombies are not just like Romero movies, like Romero. It's mass consumerism. It's people being sheep and following. Right. That's what his themes and thematic are running through those films, and it's usually the people that are worse than the creatures. For us, the give me that then.
Como con George Romero, es un poco que la gente al final se convierte en ovejas y van siguiendo, y por eso se extiende todo y va como va.
And our themes are it's kids dealing with death. It's like these. The zombies are supposed to represent this death that comes into like these teenagers' lives.
Bueno, uno de los temas sería los niños o los adolescentes cómo se enfrentan a la muerte, ¿no? Los zombies representando ese concepto de muerte.
So when you're like 16, 17, all of a sudden you start to become aware of death. You start to be, you know, realize, you know, parents pass away, grandparents pass away, friends pass away, aunties, uncles, all of a sudden. There's death all around you, it's on the news, it's everywhere. And like Santa Claus not being real, you can't reopen that door. It's there forever. And that's what these kids are dealing with, is this death that's just come into their lives.
Cuando tienes 16 o 17 años, que igual empiezas a ver las primeras muertes de tus abuelos o tíos, padres, lo que sea, te enfrentas por primera vez a ese concepto como algo real. Y dice que es un poco como cuando te enteras de que Papá Noel no existe, es una puerta que ya no la puedes cerrar, eso está ahí.
You can't just have death coming out of nowhere, like as in there's no explanation for why people die, we just die, like zombies, they're just there.
Y que no hay una razón por la que morimos, simplemente morimos, y es un poco como los zombies en su peli, no hay razón, están ahí y ya está, tienes que enfrentarte a eso.
Es interesante porque Ana tiene una ausencia en su vida, la ausencia materna. Ella quiere escapar.
There's like the absence of the mother in Anna's life, and she wants to escape.
La chica rubia, lesbiana, también tiene una ausencia. No vemos el amor que tiene que ir a buscar.
Steph also has this absence, like her girlfriend's away, not there.
His best friend también tiene una ausencia, que es ella, la chica a la que ama, que no le hace caso, lo trata como un amigo.
John's absence is Anna herself, that he can't really reach her like the way he wants.
Y el exnovio también tiene esa ausencia, que es ella. Ella en realidad pivota en toda la película a través de vínculos emocionales que se rompen o se destejen en todo momento.
And also, well, the connection with the ex-boyfriend, that his absence is also her, in a way. So she's like a lot of times the pivot of everyone else, that she's like in the center of all of this connection.
Eso para mí es una manera de guión muy interesante porque engrasas cualquier relación que hay en los diferentes personajes.
So for him it's like a really interesting way to make a movie because there's the relationships in between all of the characters are very much it's very much like a natural way of them going about together.
So it's a teenage movie. It's a and as I said, it's about teenagers, and teenagers are full of angst. They're just so angsty, and the first two songs are so angsty.
Es una peli de adolescentes y los adolescentes tienen mucha rabia en su interior y las dos primeras canciones son súper rabiosas.
And all their problems are so big, like they have so many problems, and it's like and if this girl doesn't like them, it's the end of the world. And the fact that you know, our father's being overbearing and saying you can't do this is the end of the world. Steph's parents are gone to Mexico and she didn't want to go, and now our girlfriend's not there. So it's the end of the world. Like,
para los adolescentes sus problemas son los más importantes y los más grandes del mundo,
del
¿no? De Ana, su padre no le deja hacer lo que quiere, o sea, se acaba el mundo. Steph, la chica lesbiana, sus padres se van a México sin ella, su novia no está, es el problema más grande del mundo. A John, la chica que le gusta, no le hace caso, se acaba el mundo para ellos.
And now we have the end of the world.
Y pero se acaba el mundo de verdad en esta peli.
Veo que la película ha viajado mucho, ha estado en muchos festivales, siempre en el fantástico, porque tú, la idea era hacer, la idea de que encajara la película en este tipo de festivales, certámenes, en el fantástico.
So, lots of festivals for this movie, lots of traveling, lots of fantastic festivals. Was it your idea to, when you were making the movie, that this would be a good fit for fantastic, like, genre festivals?
No, our sales agents were brilliant like that, like XYZ and AMP. They identified places for it to go and understood that. I'd done the festival circuit with my first film, but that was, as I say, it was a romantic comedy. But I go to horror festivals. Like I used to save up so much. Me and my best friend would save up all year to go to Fright Fest, where we would buy a pass for the whole weekend. We'd have our hotel and it would be just so super excited.
No, para él fue esto, fue eso, los agentes de venda. IMP y XYZ, que hicieron bueno, cuáles son los festivales para esta película. Él tenía experiencia con los festivales con su primera peli, pero que era una comedia romántica, totalmente distinto. Y bueno, él siempre ha sido fan de los festivales de terror, aparte de esto.
¿Y cómo fue el feedback con el público? ¿Qué te preguntaban? ¿Qué les interesaba de la película?
So how was the feedback with the audience? Like, what would they ask you? What would they most be interested in after watching?
I don't know, like, what's been great is people just kind of thrown themselves into this movie. They're not taking it too seriously. Most of the time people are digging it. There's a couple of people that dislike it, but that's, you're always going to get that.
Por la mayor parte del tiempo a la gente le encanta. Es una película que es muy divertida y se lo pasa muy bien.
There's a really good one, which was when I was in Korea. I got asked three different times in the same Q&A if this film was about Brexit.
En Corea le preguntaron tres veces en el mismo turno de preguntas si esta peli iba sobre el Brexit.
It's not. We hate, and I had to keep on saying, I hate Brexit, I think Brexit's shit. But it's just, this is a zombie movie set at Christmas about teenagers. So yeah, I think that's the most craziest question I've been asked, as I say, three times. But usually people are just so excited to find out where the idea came from, and they're so excited to find out, you know, what's next. Now, that's the kind of like the sort of the real questions that everybody sort of asks.
Esta peli no va del Brexit. Él odia el Brexit, pero esta es una peli de zombies. La pregunta que quizás más le han hecho es de dónde viene la idea de esta película y también cuáles son los próximos proyectos.
Y ahora para terminar, me gustaría que me dijeras qué película cambió tu mirada como espectador o una de ellas, porque seguramente habrá muchísimas.
So, one movie that changed your view as an audience, like a movie that changed like the way you see movies.
There's a few. I mean, I just love film. I love cinema. And it depends as well. So like, when I watched like John Carpenter movies, I realized that I didn't like, you know, you didn't just have to do horror. You could do horror comedy, or you could do action comedy, you could do action sci-fi, sci-fi horror.
Le encanta todo el cine, pero por ejemplo cuando vio pelis de Carpenter se dio cuenta de que no tienes que hacer solo terror, que puedes hacer terror y comedia o acción, que puedes mezclar géneros.
The Evil Dead movies by Sam Raimi, like when I was young watching them, like those were like, the first one was terrifying as a young man. Then I watched the second one and I laughed, that I realized that you can shift and change.
Las pelis de Sam Raimi de Los Muertos Vivientes, la primera le asustó un montón cuando era joven, la segunda se rió.
Then I saw something, then I saw like Silence of the Lambs, and then watching how cinematography and framing would just also dictate about character and how they're speaking to each other and who's winning the scene.
Y en El silencio de los corderos, sobre todo, cómo la cámara va con el personaje, ¿no? Y a través de los planos, pues muestran quién está ganando en una escena, por ejemplo.
And then all of a sudden discovered Kurosawa movies and realized that, like, how every frame can be a painting and how color, like, is so important and, like, how weather is even like a factor in film.
Y luego descubrió Kurosawa, por ejemplo, que para cada plano es como una pintura. El tiempo puede ser como un personaje más en la película.
And my favorite movie of all time is Ghostbusters.
Su peli preferida es Ghostbusters.
Cazafantasmas.
Cazafantasmas.
Ghostbusters. Harold Ramis.
It's what well-crafted, well-structured story can do. You can play with horror, you can play with comedy, you can play with sci-fi, you can play with drama, and you can have so much going on. And love, yeah. Peter Venkman walking about with a syringe, you're like, he's such a lovable character.
Bueno, que esta es una peli que está muy bien estructurada y que muestra que puedes jugar con muchos géneros y muchas cosas mientras tengas una estructura sólida.
Thank you very much for your time. Y yo siempre digo hasta la próxima película.
Until next movie.
No, thank you very much. This has been so cool. Thank you for having me.